So we are looking at the questions from Tamil Nadu state eligibility test, and this is the question number 6. As you can see, this question is from theory of computations subject, which is this question is very easy. I think this is the easiest question that they might ask you in the examination hall. And what they are giving us, that we have some variables. So they are giving us a set of variables here. Let me just rub it up. And that you can see, they are giving us a set of variables. So these are the variables, and they're giving us a set of terminals. Okay, so what are the variables here? Variables are S, A and B. And what are the terminals? Terminals are small a and small b. Okay, so you can just ignore this part here because it is not at all required. This is when they are giving a set of variables, here they are giving all the set of symbols that can be variable or that can be terminals. Okay, so here you have to identify what are the variables. These variables are also called as non-terminals, and you have to identify what are the terminals. Now they are saying determine P consists of the grammar. So this is, they are giving us a grammar here, or you can say determine whether P is saying the production rules. These are the production rules. Okay, now they are giving us a production rule, they are giving us a variable, they are giving us a set of terminals. Now they are asking what type of grammar it is. Is it a type 2 grammar? Is it a type 3 grammar? It is a type 0 grammar? It is a type 1 grammar? Generally what happens is there are different types of grammar. So let me explain you the types of grammar first. We have the type 3 grammar, and type 3 grammars are also called as the regular grammar. Then we have the type 2 grammar. Now these type 2 grammars are also called as the context free grammars. Then we have the type 1 grammars, which are also called as the context sensitive grammar. And then we have the type 0 grammars, which are also called as the unrestricted grammars. Okay, now they are giving us a grammar, they are giving us a set of productions. So these are the set of productions, which are AS derives small AA and A derives small a or small b. So these are the set of productions that they are giving. Now they are asking whether it is a type 3, whether it is type 2, whether it is type 1 or so on. Correct. Now every type 3 grammar is also type 2, every type 2 grammar is also type 1, and every type 1 grammar is also type 0. So that is why these are shown like this in the set. Now what are the properties of a type 3 grammar? See, type 3 grammar is the most restrictive one. So this is the most restrictive. Okay, so that means we are having the maximum number of restrictions in type 3 grammar. So restriction says that if we have some productions, then productions can be of the form alpha derives a beta or a. So, or we can have production of the form alpha derives beta a or a. It means either the productions can be left linear or they can be right linear. So here this production is showing that this production is right linear. Okay, and this production is saying that it is left linear. So either the productions can be of left linear or they can be of right linear, but not both. Okay, so here you can see the production that they are representing. This is a right linear production. Correct. So this grammar is not having any left linear production. It is having the production which is right linear, or it is having this production. Correct. And both these productions are actually satisfying the condition of the type 3 grammar. So I can say this grammar is type 3. Now as you can see, every type 3 grammar is also type 2, every type 2 is also type 1, and every type 1 is also type 0. Correct. Now so when they are saying that it is type 3 but not type 2, that is the correct answer, because actually every type 3 is also type 2, right? And okay, well, let us read out the options one by one. So first option is saying it is type 2 only. Okay, it is type 3 but not type 2, it is type 2 but not type 1, and none of the above. Okay, now you can see that I've given you definition of type 3. Now what type 2 says, what is it, when do you call a grammar as type 2? So for a grammar to be of type 2, if all the productions are of the form, number 1, it should be type 3, it should satisfy the conditions of type 3, and number 2, that if the production of the form alpha derives beta, now this left hand side, the length of the left hand side should be 1, that is, it should be exactly one variable, and the right hand side can be combination of any variables or terminals. So it can be any combination of variables or terminals, right? And when we have a type 1 grammar. Now type 1 grammar says, first of all, it should be type 2. It should be type 2. And secondly, the if we have alpha productions, alpha derives beta, then the length of alpha should be less than or equal to the length of beta. And secondly, alpha can be any combination of variable union terminal plus or variable plus terminal. Okay. So this sign is important. And beta can be any combination of variable plus terminal star. Okay. And when I'm saying type 0, then type 0 more unrestricted. So in type 0, this condition is also not there. Correct. Now here, in this question, they are saying us that this is the grammar. Now we found out that this grammar is satisfying the condition of type 3. So obviously, if it is satisfying the condition of type 3, then it is also satisfying the condition of type 2. Then also it is satisfying the condition of type 1. And also it is satisfying the condition of type 0. So first option is saying it is a type 2 only. So, but we know that it is type 1, it is type 3, type 2, type 1, as well as type 0. So this cannot be a correct answer. I feel so. You may write your answer in the comment box here, because I will be more interested in reading your solutions and reading your logics also. In type B saying it is type 3 but not type 2. So that is wrong. And option number C is saying it is type 2 but not type 1. So that is also wrong. And option D, none of the above is the correct answer. So for me, the correct answer is option number D. But I'll be more interested in reading your answers here. And I'll be waiting for your comments. So the correct answer is option number D for this. Okay. And let us look at the question number 7 here.